Hey everybody, it's me, Dylan Winspear. Hey everybody, it's me, your host, Dylan Winspear. Hey everyone, Dylan Winspear here with Design Today. Hey all you cool cats and kittens, it's Carol. Hey everyone, welcome back to another quick rant for the Design Today podcast. Designers get a bad rap for always wanting to redesign things. Redesign this, redesign that. This isn't working, let's redesign it again and again and again. Redo after redo for seemingly no apparent reason. In fact, if you jump onto Behance and search for Facebook redesign, you'll be loaded with a whole bunch of options and iterations. That in and of itself isn't a bad thing. If you're sitting at home and are practicing for the sake of practice, keep it up. But when a designer sits in a room by his or herself designing UX of a product by themselves, we miss many key points. Today's rant is on context. I was introduced to a new principle of design by a friend of mine, Ben Peck. He shared something on social media, which was something I'd never heard of before. And in truth, it isn't a quote unquote real UX principle, but I think it applies here nonetheless. It's called the Chesterton principle, or also known by the name Chesterton's fence. It was written in 1929 by G.K. Chesterton in a book titled The Thing. The idea revolves around this analogy of a fence placed across a road. Before I read you this excerpt, I want you to picture this long dirt road in the middle of the country. It's on this dirt road that you're gonna encounter this fence blocking the road further. Let me read you the excerpt now. Bear with me as it gets a little wordy, but I don't wanna paraphrase this paragraph. So here it goes. In the matter of reforming things as distinct from deforming them, there is one plain and simple principle, a principle which will probably be called a paradox. There exists in such a case a certain institution or law, let us say for the sake of simplicity, a fence or gate erected across a road. The more modern type of reformer goes galley up to it and says, I don't see the use of this, let's clear it away. To which the more intelligent type of reformer will do well to answer this. If you don't see the use of it, I certainly won't let you clear it away. Go away and think. Then when you can come back and tell me that you do see the use of it, I may allow you to destroy it. I'm sure you've been on a project that you inherited from someone else. Maybe there's a previous designer who started the project, or you're adding to an existing project. Nonetheless, let's imagine you're working on a project that isn't starting from scratch. It's all too easy to assume the previous designer wasn't as smart as you, and that you can start cutting all the pieces that you now deem unnecessary. Don't. The Chesterton principle would tell you that before we can start tearing things down, we need to understand why it was placed there to begin with. Let me say it louder for the people in the back. You don't know why it was done in the first place. Until you can answer that question, you shouldn't be redesigning anything. You see, there's always going to be context missing in this scenario. Context from stakeholders, users, developers, etc. If you don't know the context, how can you be making informed decisions? Don't be the designer redesigning because you think you're better than the designers before you. Before you destroy what's in front of you, first seek to understand why it was there to begin with. Only after that will you be smart enough to change it. That's it. Quick and easy today. The Chesterton principle. Log that one away in the future for references. Take care. Stay home. Stay safe. Stay healthy. We'll see you.